over that sometimes. She's doing good. Michael, Shanna, come on up. This is Michael, Shanna Capps. Shanna is my youngest of three daughters. For those that don't know, a lot of you know her. And Michael. We come today to just dedicate this little sweet one to the Lord. Psalms 127, 3-5 tells us, children are a rare heritage from the Lord, offspring of reward from Him, like an arrow in the hands of a warrior are children. Born are you, blessed is the man whose quiver is full. Remember that. The more the merrier. No pressure. Go to Mary. Today we come to dedicate Savannah, to the Lord. Baby dedication is not only a time of celebration of the birth of a child, but an important coming before the Lord and the family to commit this child before the Lord. Dedicating a baby is not like baptizing, right? We're going to dedicate her to the Lord. Looking forward to the day when the Lord, she comes to know the Lord and she is baptized. Dedicating her child, we're just recognizing that this child belongs to the Lord. As parents, we're just here for a short time with them. We're going to train them, teach them, and love them, and send them out in the world to go and do God's work. So, Scripture speaks of dedicating children for the Lord. Back in Deuteronomy 6 and 7 says, O hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. You shall love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength. And these words which I command to you today shall be on your heart. I command these to Shanna and Mike. You shall teach them diligently to your children. You shall talk to them when they sit down in the house and when they walk by the way, when you lie down and when you rise up. Deuteronomy makes it clear it is parents' job to train the children of the Lord. It's your job. Take it serious. Baby dedication is also seen in 1 Samuel, when Hannah dedicated Samuel to the Lord, and also in Luke, when Mary and Joseph dedicated Jesus in the temple. So dedication is there. It's in Scripture and it tells us to do that. It is good to present your child before God, committing to love and teach them about the Lord. It is our prayer that God will use His child to His glory. That's what we all want, right? So I'm going to ask the grandmothers to come up. Grandma, a couple grandmas here. I'm going to read some stuff, and after I read this, if you agree, which I know you will, just say we do. Do you, Shanna and Mike, promise to commit to the Lord, Savannah, to help her to know the Lord with all her heart, with all her mind, and all her soul? You promise to love Savannah by being an example of her, of His grace in your daily life. Do you? Grandmas, do you hereby promise to faithfully teach Savannah all the ways of the Lord and have her and love her by being an example to her and living in grace to you? I do too. Congregation, we come and ask you. So, as a congregation of friends and family, do you promise to support the family in prayer for them? Do you promise to encourage them and seek to nurture and guide Savannah in the ways of the Lord? Do you?
We do.
Let's pray. Let's get down to prayer. Father, we come now to lift up Savannah to you, Father. We just ask that you will continue to be with her, to hold her, to guide her towards you. Lord, we just pray that you would, as we prayed in the past, Father, you will continue to nurture her and draw her to you. Father, looking for the day, Lord, that she comes to know you. Promise that we, as her grandparents and her parents, will continue to live our lives and teach her and help her to grow closer to you, Father. We thank you for her. Father, she is truly a blessing sent by you, as all children are. We thank you and ask you to bless her. Bless her life, Father, in Jesus' precious name, we pray. Good girl. As usual. Yes, I want to introduce the rest of my family real quick. Heather, bring your children up with you. Heather, this is my Heather, my oldest daughter. Savannah is number six. Amber, come on up with yours. Heather has, I have Caitlin and Adam. Adam just turned 18 the other day. So we have a wide variety there. Amber and Heather is holding Ollie, which I call her, and her name is Olivia. And Nevin. So they're the others too. So Savannah's at the end right now, hoping that we have many more. Thank you.
Straight and narrow way for your purpose. dedicate this baby.